Hi, Alex here from Rebelliper.com and welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having a great day. And today we are going to create a UI image picker controller. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay. Go ahead and click the link down below in the description so you can take a look at the starter project. Once you download it or clone it from GitHub, you will be presented of a folder structure just like this. Well, not quite, because you will need to install the pods, only tiny constraints, to your project. So what you need to do first is go ahead and open up terminal and type in cd and a space, and just simply drag and drop the root folder of your project. Hit return and type in pod install and return. I won't do it now because it's already installed. You will then install your pods, and the pod file lock will appear, and so on. From now on, you can open up your project with the Xcode workspace. So let's do that and let's see what we are going to build out today. Okay, let me just resize this and let's just go to the master. Yep, we are in the master, and that is the finished version of our project. So I will just simply select iPhone XR and build and run the project. You will see what we are going to build out. Basically, we are going to create an image picker, and that is for our profile picture. And it is building up. Here we go. Let's just wait for it. We will have just simple circle button, and behind that we have our image. Currently it has this default profile image in it. If we tap on it, we can see that we can choose a photo from our library, or we can take a new photo. Of course, we are in the simulator, so we won't take a new photo, but go ahead and plug in your device, and then you can select this one too, and then we can choose a photo. Let's just wait for that. Let's select this one, let's choose it, and there we go, we have selected our photo. Now we have our image inside our image view. So let's take a look at the starter project. So I will just check out the starter branch of the repo, and go ahead, you two should switch if you already haven't downloaded the starter project. And inside the root view controller, we have our profile image view, our profile image button, simple, rounded. I won't go into detail, go ahead and take a look at the layers and so on, what we have here. And we have our profile image button tab, Objective-C file private function that is triggered once we tap on the image button. And we constrain it with the help of tiny constraints. That is why we needed to install the pods. So if we build and run now, we will just see that this tapped profile image button will be printed out in the console log. So let's just wait for that. There we go, tapped profile image button. So let's start building out our photo image picker view. So we are going to create an extension for this. So extension, and we are going to extend our root view controller. And for now, we won't add any super classes for our root view controller. What we want to create here is, let's see, let's create a function that will be called in the profile image button. So now we want to create the show image picker controller function, and let's just do that. Show image picker controller. And this will basically show the image picker controller. And for that, we need to confirm to image UI image picker, UI image. Sorry about that. Image picker controller delegate. There we go. And UI navigation controller delegate. Now, why do we need UI navigation controller delegate? That is because we will navigate to another, let's so-called view controller, that is the UI image picker view controller. So that is why we are going to simply just present it. Okay, so let's create a new image picker controller. I would just name this image picker controller, and it will be a UI image picker controller. And finally, let us just add our delegate image picker controller delegate equals self, so we can listen for events. And finally, we want to present our image picker controller animated true, completion nil, or we could just delete completion altogether, but that's what it is. So let's copy this function name and add it in the profile image button tab, and let's build and run with command R, so we can see that indeed we do get the image picker presented. So let's console out of that. Yeah, but how do we know that we have consoled? Well, that is with the help of a delegate function. So let's call on some delegate functions. Basically, we are going to call on only one delegate function, did finish image picker controller, did finish picking media with info. So now we can get our info, and from that info we are going to extract the image. So first of all, let us just dismiss our image picker controller. So dismiss animated true completion nil, and let me just comment this out and build and run again, so you may see that actually once we select an image, nothing really happens. It does not dismiss the controller. So let's select this. Okay, I have selected an image, but nothing happens. Okay, but now if we do have this dismiss animated, then once we pick an image, the image picker controller is actually dismissed. So let's just wait for that and see. There we go. Okay, now it's time to add in some image picker controller stats or options, and let us just do that in the show image picker controller. Image picker controller allows editing equals to true, that is so we can pan and zoom and pinch or whatever we would like to do with the selected image before we choose it. And image picker controller, and there's something called source type, and it is a UI image picker controller source type, and that is basically, let me just add it in here, it's basically if you want to choose the photo library, the camera. I will choose the photo library for now, but we will just build out in just a few moments that we can choose photo library and camera too. Okay, next up, we want to extract the image from our info in did finish picking media with info. So before the dismissal of our controller, let us just create our image here equals info. There's a key UI image picker controller info key, and there are a lot, but we are going to select edited image because as you could see, we are allowing editing image. Of course, there is an original image info key. We will just create that in just a moment. So let's just name this edited image and as UI image. And let us just take a look if there is if let edited image equals from that info. Then we are going to grab that edited image and add it to our profile image view. That is right. So profile image view dot image equals edited image. Okay, and that should take care of that. Else if, and I'm just going to simply copy this out and paste it in there, let original image, and the info key in our case is original image, then we are going to add that profile image to our profile image views image property. And that is it. We are handling both the edited image that we get, if we do get it, or the original image. So let us just build and run and see if we do get it. And yeah, and that should conclude the basics of it, but we are going to do even more. So for now, let us just choose. There we go. Pretty simple. But what if we wanted to just choose this one? What if we wanted to allow the camera to? So that is what we are going to build out here. And as you can see, the image picker controller has the source type set to photo library. Now I want to make this a variable, so I will type in here source type, and that will be of type UI image picker controller source type, and I will just simply add that in there. Now it's up to us to select the source type with the show image picker controller, and for that we are going to, first of all, let's just delete this function because it doesn't exist anymore, and create a new one that will show an actions sheet. So func show image picker controller action sheet, and we are going to show an action sheet with a lot of two actions, basically three actions, including the cancel. So what we have here is an alert service that has a static function called show alert, and we are going to use that. Basically it makes our life much easier showing alerts, in our case an action sheet. So let us just type in alert service show alert, and we are going to choose this one with the UI alert action array. So the style will be action sheet, the title, let's say choose your image. For the message, we'll just add in nil, and now come the actions. So let's create our first action, let, and the first action should be choosing the photo library. So photo library action equals, and this will be a UI alert action with a title of choose from library. Okay, style and default will be just fine, and the handler, here we have our action. We are not going to use it for now, but we are going to call this image picker controller function. So self.image picker controller one with the source type. Maybe I just need to hit command B so we can get the completion. And yes, with the source type show image picker controller, sorry about that. Okay, and we are going to use the photo library here. Now the second one, I'm just again copy and paste, will be the camera action, and And let's say take from camera. Okay, or whatever you would like. This capital L. Okay, and now we have our type to be camera. Okay, finally, we need to have a cancel action. And that is a UI alert action with the title cancel. And the style should be canceled and nothing for the handler. So let's add that to the actions array. So there we go. Photo library action, camera action, and the cancel action. And the completion will be nil here. And that should conclude everything that we need to do today. So, finally. One last step, and this is not camera action, should be console action. Let me just copy and paste that in there. And let's call this show image picker controller action sheet from our button tabbed function. Okay. And I will just delete this print statement because it's no longer necessary. And yeah, you should keep your clothes clean. So let's tap on that. Choose your image. Choose from library. Take from camera. So I will choose from library for now. Let me just choose this one. Let me just edit this with Alt. And I will just make this a little bit larger. Let's choose that. There we go. We have our image added to our profile image. And of course, you can move on and maybe save it to Firebase storage or whatever you would like to do with this image. Now, that is it for today. And I hope you enjoyed learning about UI image picker controller and how easy it is to use. If you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe for the channel and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out on the channel. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and add UI image picker controller into your own apps and do let me know how it went in the comments down below. Or if you have a question, just comment down below, I answer them as soon as I can. And as always, I will see you in the next one.